in Texas desert reptiles. The desert is a really, really hot place in the daytime and very cold at night. And it's very little water, so it makes it harder to survive. So how do animals live there? Here are three animals with their physical and behavioral adaptations that help them survive the hard challenges of the desert, day and night. The first animal I will be talking about is the Texas horned lizard. The Texas horned lizard has blood in its eyes that it's ready to shoot. So if a predator or prey gets too close, it can use its physical adaptation to squirt blood out of its eyes and into the other predator's eyes, mouth, and nose. The next thing about that is it also has channels on its back. If water lands there, any fog, mist, dust, any type of water gets there, it just opens and closes its mouth and it makes waterways that travel up to its mouth. If it just opens and closes it, then the water gets in and it gets hydrated. The next thing I will be talking about is it has pointy claws. Those claws are very sharp to make it scary. And it also has spikes on its back. And those spikes are everywhere to make it look scarier and harder to eat. It also can puff up like a pufferfish. And because it can, it's really flat. And because it's flat, it can just lie down on the ground like this, and the predator would just walk right past it. No shadow made. And it also has horns, like spiky, bony horn things on its head. And they're hard and scary and make it look scarier or harder to eat, that kind of thing. And it also has, that's my favorite animal out of these three animals. The next animal I will be talking about is the Texas banded gecko. One of its behavioral adaptations is that it can pull up its tail like a scorpion. If predators get too close, then it will scare them away. Then it gets time to escape and hide in a tiny crack. Because this animal is this big, like really small, so it can hide in places other animals can't get to. It also has a special tongue that can sense and smell and sense stuff. If like a predator or prey is nearby, if it can touch its tongue to stuff and like sense it, like know what it is and all that cool stuff. It also has very large eyes because it's nocturnal. Like, have you seen an owl with those large eyes? That helps it see in the dark, just like the Texas banded gecko. The Texas banded gecko has clawed feet, and it doesn't have the suction cups on its feet like others. And to help it make the scorpion, it has a long, long tail that if the scorpion doesn't work, it just drops off its tail and runs away and hides in a crack. The next animal I will be talking about is the rattlesnake. The rattlesnake has a pits around its mouth, kind of like nose, but different because it senses heat. It's a heat-sensitive pit. And it senses if heat and predators are prey, or nearby. It also has fangs. These fangs can bite in to the predator and inject, like it's a venom kind of thing. And the predator or prey will get stung. If it's predator, the snake will slither away. If it's prey, it'll just open its mouth right back up and eat it. The rattlesnake also has a forked tongue. Because let's say there's a cookie over here and broccoli over here. Most people would choose the cookie. And so he would go towards the cookie. And it also has the famous part of the rattlesnake, the rattle. That's why it's called the rattlesnake. And it's made of this stuff, kind of like skin, that rubs together to make the rattle sound. There is nothing even in there. And these are just three animals of our ecosystem. But all three animals have scales and can camouflage. This ecosystem is ginormous. And it's like an ecosystem is a way of connecting animals and rocks and dirt and stuff like that. It connects non-living and living things all together. That's what an ecosystem is. How can I help my ecosystem? I know I can help my ecosystem by picking up trash and putting them in the recycling bin and throwing away more recyclable stuff and getting more recyclable stuff or using things